okay, and I hope you're all keeping safe. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today I'm going to be talking about being raised by a single mom. Well, a lot is said about people who have been raised by single moms, and I see it a lot on social media where people are being told that if you end up marrying a girl or maybe even a guy who has been raised by a single mom, you're going to live to regret it, and so on and so on, of which personally I find it so wrong. Let me first talk about the experience I had being raised by a single mom, and also the challenges, because well, it wasn't all walk in a park. Of course, it had its pair of challenges. So being raised by a single mom entailed a lot of moving. It entailed a lot of not seeing my mom, and it entailed a lot of being brought up by other people except my mom, and not in a bad way before you start judging. It was in a good way because she was constantly looking for work to manage to pay our bills and pay me and my brother's school fees. So yeah, so the reason why I'm saying it entailed a lot of moving, it's because one time you will find us in Umoja, the next time we're in Isili, the next time we are in Karatina, and so on. And the reason why I'm saying it entailed a lot of not seeing her, and I think I'm going to combine that with being brought up by different people, it's the fact that I remember there was a time she was I can't remember where she was staying, in Nairobi, and I was staying with my auntie in Kiambu, and my baby brother was staying with another auntie of ours in Muranga. So you see, it entailed a lot of not seeing her, and it also entailed a lot of being brought up by other people except my mom. So it got to a point, she got a job in Karatina, and after she got a job in Karatina, that's when tulikusanyika sisi wote kama familia, the three of us, that's my mom, me and my brother, and tukaenda sisi wote Karatina. So, and at least that during that time, at least we got that bond, at least that hatujuani, you know, because the constant not seeing each other, like how people, you know, like being brought up in a family where you have both parents, and you wouldn't even imagine how life would be without staying with your parents, for you who have the privilege of having both parents. But for us, that was such an amazing opportunity. I think I was in class 4 or class 3, so at least we got an opportunity to stay together for a while, because after some time she got a job in Nairobi, and she also wanted us, if I'm not wrong, if my memory serves me right, she wanted us to all move together to Nairobi, and I think Mindo nilikata, and I was like, yo, apana, this is, the moving is too much. So I think I'm the one who preferred staying in Karatina. Like I told you guys in my bio that I was brought up in Ushago by my grandma. I'm the one who decided that she can go solo, and we are comfortable in Keshagi, being brought up by my grandma. So, but the good thing is that even if she got promoted and got a job in Nairobi, she would constantly come to visit us every weekend. And I remember there was someone who was telling my shosho that my mom will stop visiting her because she was visiting us every weekend at because of her kids that are still there. But my mom is so determined. Oh my god, that woman, I love her. She always goes, even yetu sai amefungiwa, where she is. Yeah, we still don't stay together in Nairobi, and she is in another county, but she still goes to visit shosho. At least during that time we got that unity, but I wouldn't say that I think atujai ishi pamoja ever since that time. And I will say that being brought up by a single mom had also its pair of challenges, because for example, you see like how girls, when they're growing up and they get to bond with their mothers and maybe get to be taught stuff. I think vitu kama kupika ata kama nachomea picha, I'm learning them as old as I am right now, and honestly I don't regret it, because at the end of the day she is the one who is constantly teaching me, you know, sending me recipes and telling me this is how you're supposed to do it, and so on and so on. Well, it wasn't easy for what I would say is that it wasn't easy being brought up by a single mom. It wasn't. But at the same time, I wouldn't want to go back and maybe change anything, because honestly, I was okay being brought up like that, because trust me, I turned out just fine. Or what do you guys think? Honestly, I did. And as much as considering the fact that maybe being brought up by a single mom and not having a male figure in my life has caused maybe some issues here and there, where I will talk about in my next video, you guys don't want to miss that video. It's true that it had some sort of impact on my life, that I won't deny. But at the same time, challenges that of being brought up by a single mama. Because, for example, I remember there was a time when we were still staying in Karatina, in primary school. You remember how tulikuwa tunasongwa? Cornrows. Zinaitwa cornrows. Hizi lines za kurudi nyuma. So it's the holiday is over. My mom is not around, but my auntie, a certain auntie, was around. Hiyo holiday nilikuwa nimeshukua lines za kurudi nyuma with my own hair. Because I have a long hair, excuse me. Because I have a long hair. So nilikuwa tu nimeshukua lines za kurudi nyuma. And also, nilikuwa sasa nimepaka fashion. To rasters, to tatu tunasonga hapa na tumekuwa beads. So, we're going back to school on Monday. And today is Sunday. Na bado sijakomboa. And I'm talking to my auntie. I'm telling her, tomorrow niko shule. And I need something to be done about my hair. Akasema, tutajua tu. Okay, tutajua na niko shule kesho. Imagine, nilikuwa tu in bed, nikaona nikuwe smart, because mimi ndio ninajua the following day, si mimi ndio nitafukuzwa, sitakuwa na my auntie or anyone else, I'll just be by myself. I was smart, nilibomoa the rasters that were here, nikai twist in a very nice way, then nikairudisha hapa nyuma kwa line. And then that week I had to be extra careful, like nisishake kichwa hivi. Unaona kama vile nimeka the tab on, imagine tu nikifanya hivi and then itokane. It was the same thing, like hapo kakitu I had to eka kanywele kalikuwa hapo ndani, and I had to be very careful in a way that, you know, sitaharibu ama nichome anyway. So that is just to show you that of course it had its pair of challenges, and as an individual, I had to learn ways on how to deal with it, and how to know that my mom is such an amazing human being. And honestly, I have never lacked anything. I have never slept on an empty stomach. I can't complain about anything. So it really breaks my heart when I see people on social media saying that people who have been brought by single parents, it's like they say it in a way, it's like we have some sort of problem, you know, like that you will regret it for the rest of your life. I actually talked to my mom about this, and she was like, the people who think that way are so very wrong, because that was her story. She already wrote her story, and this is my own story that I am supposed to write. So it's not like being single or the issues that people say we have, it's not like it's supposed to be hereditary, you know. It's not like, okay, let's say my mom, Mama Brenda, it's not like now in me it's Mama Brenda season 2. She wrote her story, and right now I'm supposed to be writing my own story, and it doesn't have to be the same, and it doesn't have to be like, hey, Brenda was brought up by a single mom, she has her own issues. Well, we are going to discuss on the next video. Honestly, being raised by a single mom had its pair of challenges, but I wouldn't change it for anything. Like, maybe if I were told to go back and change something about it, I wouldn't change it, because mom, I love you so very much. Thank you so much. Look at me now, here I am right now, and my baby brother as well, and I can say we're in a better place, and I wouldn't trade you for anything, because you're my friend. I know maybe growing up we didn't maybe like have very many conversations, maybe when it came to boys or even cooking. I remember we just talked once about boys, and that was when she was telling me to stay away from my current boyfriend back then, because he ended up being my cousin, but that is story for another day. But you're my friend right now, and you have always been my friend, and I will live to celebrate you, and I love you so very much, because as old as I am right now, when I'm stuck or when I need help, you're the person that I always run to. And I love you so very much. May God bless you. May God fulfill the desires of your heart. And yes, I'm this close to being emotional and I don't want to hurt. Mama, please just know that I love you so very much. And I wouldn't trade you for anything, and I wouldn't trade my childhood for anything in this world, no matter what people say about us, people who have been brought by single mothers. And today being Mother's Day, I celebrate all mothers, single mothers, name it, like all mothers, because you guys are just the best. You guys are just the bomb. Because right now, maybe back then we didn't have child cares, but right now there are single moms who are really working themselves off to go to work and at the same be a mother, leaving their babies at child care, there. And even guys, you can bear me witness that when celebrities are giving their speeches, most of the time they are like, I dedicate this to my mom and so on. So honestly, I celebrate all mothers today. Happy Mother's Day. And for guys who don't have that relationship with their mothers, I'm really, really sorry. And just be strong, because I know that there are people out here who don't have relationships with their moms. So that's why it hurts me when people want to like judge us because of being brought up by single moms. There are people out here who would wish for that single mother to just be loving and be available to their needs. But anyway, guys, I'll see you in the next video, and trust me, you don't want to miss the next video, because I'm going to be talking about these issues where we are told that being brought up by a single mom has brought us. Thank you so very much, guys, for the support, and thank you for having my back. I think right now we are at 349 subscribers. Thank you so very much. May God bless you. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Bye.